Greetings, I'm Dr. Kim Kyung-won. Today we are going to look at surgical video clip and review the case together. And we will look at the patient, 74-year-old male patient. There's no special medical history. The patient did have acute cholecystitis. However, it's not a big problem. The patient came in approximately in April. If you look at lower left molar, there's pain and mobility in the teeth. I took panoramic image number 36, and the tooth behind that is connected in bridge. I think number 7 was missing and number 8 was mesially tilted, and it was connected using bridge. The two teeth are connected as shown. However, complete alveolar bone destruction occurred distally. At number 36, there was mobility and the patient complained of pain. At the day of the visit, the patient complained of a lot of pain and two teeth were extracted. I think the posterior tooth was number 38. Extraction was done. This is 2 months after extraction. Soft tissue healing is complete. The extraction socket itself is not fully healed. I plan for implant placement using one guide. CT was taken. If you look at the CT image, you can see the extraction socket of number 36. There's no issue with the width and the amount of alveolar bone here. And the height is okay as well. There's extraction socket here. It's not fully healed. The height of alveolar bone, it's okay. Number 37. The distance to inferior alveolar nerve is approximately 8 to 9 millimeter. In order to have secure space, I plan to place a 7 millimeter implant. This is not a fully healed extraction socket. Distal to tooth number 6, the alveolar bone is slightly higher, and using this as a basis, implant placement was planned. I talked with Austin One Guy, the team, to come up with a surgical plan. In number 36, diameter 5.0 KS3 implant was planned. This was 10 millimeters, and the distance with inferior alveolar nerve was okay. And in number 37, the distance with inferior alveolar nerve is approximately 9 to 10 millimeter. However, I wanted to be safe and place it deep, and I planned for 5.0 by 7 millimeter implant placement. This is the extraction socket. The alveolar bone state is fairly favorable. KS3 5.0 implants were planned in number 36, 10 millimeter. In number 37, 7 millimeter implants were planned. In the most distal area, we need to consider patient's level of mouth opening. And the one guide template, I made it in an open sleeve type to be used for surgery. Two implants are now placed. This is a post-op image. Primary stability was good. Healing abutments were connected. If you look at the post-op CT in the case of number 36, it sufficiently engages the alveolar bone. In the case of number 37, distally, it's not really fully formed. However, you can see that the implant has been placed as planned. Two implants were placed. Looking back, distal to number 37, I wish I would have done a little bit of a bone graft. However, there were no major issues. Let's look at the surgical clip. It has been about 2 months since extraction. One guided template. In number 36, it is closed the sleeve. In number 37, considering patient's level of mouth opening, it is open sleeve. One guide template is now adapted to patient mouth to check whether it fits right. Because it is most distal tooth, the attached gingiva is quite limited, and crestal incision is made. Flap is slightly reflected. I'm going to forego punch and proceed with surgery. I did not reflect the flap too much. I only did it slightly to secure space for drilling. I have now positioned the template. Using the guide hole, you check with your eyes whether the flap is slightly reflected, and then drilling is done. Initial drill, one guide initial drill is used, and drilling is done in number 36. You need to check whether the drill goes in fully. Next, I'm going to use 3.5 by 10 millimeter one guided drill for drilling. Because of the angle, you cannot really see it, and it hits the mesial teeth. You cannot really see. However, drilling is done. Next, the 5.0 by 10 millimeter one guide drill is used. Full length drilling is done. Drilling is now complete. KS3BA surface 5.0 by 10 millimeter implant has been prepared. BA is hydrophilic implant, and before you place it, you need to irrigate it sufficiently to reduce the possibility of infection. The patient has had chronic periodontitis for quite a while, and the alveolar bone is quite hard. Final torque is sufficient. I have placed implant in number 36. Initial drilling is going to be done in number 37. This is open sleeve type. You need to fit it well into the lingual side, or else the path can alter. Because this is an open sleeve, you need to be cautious. Use the closed part on the lingual side. 3.5 by 7 millimeter one guided drill is used for drilling. This is an open hole type sleeve. When you drill, you need to be more aware of the path. Drilling is now complete. KS3BA surface 5.0 by 7 millimeter implant is used. This is a hydrophilic surface, therefore you need to irrigate it sufficiently using saline. And then you can place the implant. In the case of number 36, ISQ value is 72. In the case of distal tooth, it's approximately 78.
Yeah, 다 됐습니다.
healing abutments are connected, interrupted suture is done. I did not open flap significantly, and therefore there is no major issue in suturing. I placed the two implants using one guide. In the case of most distal tooth, you need to consider the level of mouth opening of the patient. I chose open sleeve type. You need to bear in mind when you drill with one guide drill. In this case, buccal side is open, so you need to use the lingual side to get retention and check the position of the hole as you drill. Thank you for watching.